Our first guest's job is like a giant jigsaw puzzle with 1,000 pieces. And all those pieces are fragile and irreplaceable. And also stuck in rock. That's called paleontology. Erica Hernandez has the story.
The coolest bones are always and forever dinosaur bones. Look at them. But what does it take to actually pull fossils out of solid rock? To find out, today I'm meeting with Myria Perez, a paleontologist at the Perez Museum in Dallas, Texas.
I am a fossil preparator, which means I get to release dinosaur bones and other fossils from rock.
So you're actually preparing them. You're working on them before they end up in an exhibit.
Yes.
And what are you working on right now?
We got a new jacket from the field of what we think is this dinosaur, Pachyrhinosaurus.
Okay, what do you mean by jacket?
So fossils come from the field to the museum, and we got to make sure that they're supported and that they're safe when they're traveling, because they are very fragile.
Sure.
So a jacket is a plaster and burlap case that surrounds it. You'll be able to cut one open when we go inside. Shall we go to the lab?
I would love to. This is a jacket, and we're going to open it?
We're going to open it and reveal this fossil that hasn't seen the light of day for 68 to 70 million years.
To open the jacket, we need special respirators to keep the plaster out of our lungs, eye protection, power tools,
woo!
And gloves. While Myria does the hard part, I get to help with a very advanced piece of lab equipment, a vacuum, to make sure plaster doesn't get everywhere.
We have opened the jacket, we'll take a photo to make sure we've got everything in context.
By context, she means that paleontologists keep track of exactly where the fossil was embedded in the rock and where it was in relation to other fossils. This can give them valuable clues about the type of animal, its environment, and even how it died.
And then we take small tools and we just brush it off and take away the dirt. You actually start using what's called an air scribe.
The air scribe is a special tool that's kind of like a mini jackhammer. Myria maps out a safe area for me to scribe, so I can't mess up that much.
I feel a little bit nervous knowing that I'm about to actually work on something that contains millions of years of history.
And removing the fossil from this rock could take literally weeks.
Gotta take a lot of patience to do this.
I only have patience for this, and that's it.
After you've done the exacting work of removing the fossil from the rock, it's time to figure out a dinosaur-sized puzzle.
If this fossil gets fully prepped and you see the bone and you're still like, I'm not really sure what bone this is or what part of the Pachyrhinosaurus it is, what would you do?
If I come across something that I'm not sure about, is I'll either ask my team or I'll jump the railing and compare it to the perfectly good skeleton mount of this dinosaur to make sure and see where it fits on the skeleton. So let's go take it to our skeleton and figure out where it belongs.
Okay.
So I'm thinking it's probably gonna be from the skull area. So with this piece, I really think it's part of the jaw. It's probably the lower denary.
Oh yeah.
And these are the tooth sockets. So where the teeth would be.
You're right.
This is the right denary.
Right denary, that means jaw. So we have sort of like a prepared, finished fossil here. You compared it to this skeleton to figure out where it might fit on the Pachyrhinosaurus. What do you then do with that?
So it'll either go on display later, and it'll most definitely go in collections where it'll be researched by scientists all over the world.
Wow, so they'll be using that to sort of figure out more about history.
Yes.
And you're just around all of these all day. Like, this is a room full of history, and you actually work with it.
Whenever you get kind of in a rut, or if you're working on something that's super fragile and you get a little frustrated, I always come out here and just imagine these things living and breathing, and it humbles you.
So next time you see a dinosaur in a museum, remember the skilled scientists like Myria who pulled those secrets from solid rock.